Hello friends, I am Dr. Ashish Agrawat. Welcome to my channel Live Biochemistry. Today I am going to discuss about the transgenic animals. So this will be very interesting topic, and watch this video till the end if you are new to my channel. So subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can see the future videos. So I am now sharing the screen. Okay, so as you can see, transgenic animals. So, what is transgenic animals? Genetically modified organism. Okay, they are the genetically modified organism. So, manipulation of genes to get the desired character in an animal. And what is the transgenesis? Transgenesis is a phenomenon to introduce exogenous DNA into the genome to create and maintain a stable heritable character. This is a very important definition. Then transgene is a foreign gene that is to be introduced, okay, in the host cell. And transgenic, whose genome is altered. Okay, that is that animal whose genome is altered is called as a transgenic animal. So first transgenic animal was Dolly. Okay, we will see about it. Okay. And because with the use of this transgenic animal, like transgenic cow, we can now produce lactoferrin and interferon. Transgenic goat, we can produce plasminogen activator antithrombin 3. In clotting disorder, it is very useful. Transgenic mouse for the immunoglobulin and urokinase. In the myocardial infarction, urokinase is very important. And transgenic pig, we can produce the hemoglobin. Okay, so they are very important. So first, that was produced in 1997 by the Scottish scientists E.M. Wilmot and Campbell. Okay, and there was an asexual production of the sheep. Okay. So here we know that totipotent and pluripotent, these are the stem cells which can differentiate into the tissue and organ or ultimately organism. So what they do, we'll see the procedure. So this is scientist E.M. Wilmot with the Dolly sheep. Okay, first sheep that was cloned. Okay, by the asexual production, right? So what is the procedure here in Finn Dornett sheep? Okay, the scientist took a mammary gland cell. Okay, and they kept for the 5-day starvation. So nutrient deprived cell go into the dormant totipotent cell. Okay, these are the dormant totipotent cell. Now from the another sheep, sheep 2, who has the features of black face. Okay, this sheep or ewe, from the ovum, they take the ovum cell and nucleus was removed. So a nucleated ovum was there. Now when they fuse the dormant totipotent cell from the mammary gland and the ovum cell from which nucleus is removed, in here there is nucleus is intact. Now they fuse in this fused cell, okay, and when they grow in the medium, then this embryo, okay, they grow in the culture, and once differentiation occur, then they implanted into the surrogate mother, or mainly in the black face sheep. Okay, they implanted in the black face sheep. So even though the mother has a black color face, but the Dolly that was produced had a similar feature to the Finn Dornett sheep. So why so? Because here, what happened? Because the nucleus was from the Finn Dornett sheep. Okay. So the features of the Dolly was similar to the, so as we know that in the nucleus, there is a genetic material. In the nucleus, there is a chromosome, there is a DNA which can be inherited. So because of this DNA, there is a characteristic feature of the Finn Dornett sheep. Okay, from where mammary gland cell were taken and where nucleus was there. So if we see the procedure here, from the fin dorsal sheath, memory gland cell was isolated, and to stop the normal cell cycle and to the enter in the dormant stage, they are subjected to starvation for the 5 days. Then from the black face sheep, ovum was taken and nucleus was removed, and then they were fused together. Okay, and the ovum envelope of the nucleus of the memory cell as the outer membrane is broken. Okay, and fused cell, as it had gained totipotency and multiply and grow into the embryo. Once they are grown, they are inserted into the surrogate mother. Okay, so you can see here the fin dorsal sheath from where in her mammary gland cell were taken and kept for the starvation for the 5 days. Okay, while from the black face sheep, ovum was taken and ultimately nucleus was removed. So only the membrane was there and nucleus was removed. So now only the outer layer of the ovum. Okay, and here the cell with the nucleus, now these both are fused. Okay, then allow to culture, and once differentiated, they were differentiated, they were inserted into the black face sheath. Okay, and the baby that is produced, sheep baby, that is named as a Dolly. Okay, and the feature of the Dolly was similar to the fin dorsal because of the nucleus was donated by that. So that is a type of anucleated asexual production. This is how transgenic animals are made. Okay, Dolly died in 2003 because of the lung cancer, and many experiments are still going on, and we can produce many protein by the cloning. Okay, so that is a very, very important feature. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share my video, subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon so that you can see the future video also. So thanks for watching. I hope this video will be useful to you for understanding. Okay, thank you.